January 28, 1986, as the clock says 11:38 a.m. Only 6 seconds until liftoff, or T-minus 6 seconds, as we can feel the rumble of the main engines coming to life. The air is charged with excitement, as thousands are tuned in to watch the launch of STS-51L, or better known as Space Shuttle Challenger. Cheers rise up from the ground, as the whole world has their eyes glued on the spacecraft lifts off the ground. Just 1 second past liftoff when we can hear the pilot Michael J. Smith mutter, "Here we go." The 25th mission of the NASA Space Shuttle program was underway. As the seconds slowly tick by, everyone settles in, including the first civilian teacher, Christa McAuliffe, who was part of the very first Teacher in Space program. This particular mission was planned to be around 6 days long, and the main purpose of this space visit was to observe Halley's Comet. It is T plus 70 seconds when the commander, Francis R. Dick Scobby, responds to ground command with Roger, "Go at throttle up." Little did everyone involved know that this would be the last they would ever hear from anyone aboard the Challenger. Thousands tuned in watch in horror as just 3 seconds later, the Challenger slowly disintegrates into ash. This video will go over the tragedy of this launch, all which led to this disaster and the lasting impact it created. What went wrong? In such a situation, the biggest question we all have is what went wrong? How could the Challenger space shuttle, which had 9 successful past missions, just fail? In the aftermath of the Challenger disaster, an extensive investigation was launched to determine the causes of the explosion. The inquiry, known as the Rogers Commission, was led by former Secretary of State William P. Rogers and comprised experts from various fields, including engineering, aerospace, and safety management. Their goal was to unravel the technical failures and identify what led to this tragedy. The investigation quickly identified the primary cause of the explosion, the failure of the O-rings, which are critical components designed to seal the joints of the solid rocket boosters, or SRBs. The SRBs were responsible for providing the initial thrust during launch. It was discovered that the O-rings, which were intended to prevent the hot gases produced by the burning rocket propellant from escaping, had not functioned as intended. The Challenger launch had been delayed multiple times due to the cold weather spell in hitting Florida, and even though the weather wasn't getting better, the decision was made to launch the Challenger in poor weather conditions. This ended up being a major factor for the disaster, as the Challenger ended up lifting off in temperatures low as 36 degrees Fahrenheit or 2 degrees Celsius, which were significantly colder than any previous shuttle launch. The low temperatures compromised the resiliency of the O-rings, rendering them less pliable and reducing their ability to effectively seal the joints. During the launch, as the SRBs ignited, hot gases leaked through the compromised O-rings. This breach in the seals ultimately led to the ignition of the hydrogen fuel within the tank, and causing an explosion which led to the disintegration of the Challenger, leading to the loss of all 7 crew members. However, the investigation did not solely focus on the technical failure of the O-rings. It also stressed on the significant management issues within NASA that contributed to the tragedy. The Rogers Commission determined that NASA's culture had made an environment in which safety concerns were not adequately addressed. One major issue which often compromised safety was the pressure to maintain the shuttle launch schedule. The shuttle launch program had become an integral part of NASA's operations and led to high expectations from the public and political pressures to meet launch deadlines. Lastly, the Rogers Commission highlighted a lack of effective communication channels within NASA. The concerns expressed by engineers and technical experts regarding the O-ring's performance in cold temperatures just didn't manage to reach the decision makers responsible for authorizing the launch. The Commission emphasized the need for improved communication and the importance of ensuring that critical safety information was appropriately shared and considered during the decision-making process. The real tragedy. One important thing to know here is that this was the first teacher in spaceflight planned by NASA. This meant that a civilian teacher was chosen by NASA to journey with the other astronauts to space and then be able to go back to their classroom to share the amazing experience with their students. It was designed to inspire students and teachers to always strive to be the best and inculcate an even greater admiration in the fields of mathematics and science. The program was conceived in the 1980s under the Reagan administration, and the idea was that the chosen teacher would become a symbol of hope, representing the aspirations and dreams of educators everywhere. The rigorous selection criteria encompassed both educational qualifications and personal attributes, including a deep commitment to teaching, an ability to communicate effectively, and a passion for inspiring young minds. However, this space program is tragically forever intertwined with the Challenger disaster. Christa McAuliffe, a high school teacher from New Hampshire, was the selected candidate for this historic mission. The entire nation, along with countless classrooms, eagerly awaited the launch. However, the Challenger explosion marked a devastating setback for the program and sent a shockwave through the education community. Just 4 years after the disaster, the Teachers in Space project was scrapped by NASA, and even today it still remains a painful reminder of just how deadly space can be, even with sufficient training and extensive checks. Though a silver lining of note here is that the collaborations between NASA and educators did not end here. A new program called Educator Astronaut Project was set up, which had their first successful flight as a part of NASA Astronaut Group 19 in 2004. The lasting impact. One of the most significant impacts of the Challenger disaster was the profound effect it had on public perception of space exploration. Until that moment, the space program had often been viewed as a symbol of triumph and achievement, capturing the imaginations of people worldwide. However, the Challenger explosion shattered that perception, exposing the inherent risks and dangers associated with space travel. The tragedy served as a stark reminder that even the most technologically advanced endeavors are not without their perils, prompting a sobering reassessment of the human cost of space exploration. Furthermore, the findings and the subsequent recommendations of the Rogers Commission brought about significant changes within NASA. The agency implemented thorough safety modifications and procedural improvements to prevent similar accidents in the future. The redesign of the SRBs included the addition of new joint seal designs and enhanced insulation to mitigate the effects of temperature variations. Furthermore, NASA undertook substantial efforts to transform its safety culture, fostering an environment that prioritized open communication, rigorous safety protocols, and a strong commitment to learning from past mistakes. Perhaps one of the most enduring legacies of the Challenger disaster is the lasting impact it had on the astronauts themselves. The seven crew members who perished, Francis R. Scobie, Michael J. Smith, Ronald McNair, Ellison Onizuka, Judith A. Resnick, Gregory Jarvis, and Christa McAuliffe, became symbols of courage, bravery, and sacrifice. Their untimely deaths serve as a solemn reminder of the risks undertaken by astronauts in the pursuit of scientific knowledge and exploration. Their memory continues to inspire future generations, emphasizing the importance of perseverance, dedication, and unwavering commitment to the pursuit of knowledge. The Challenger disaster serves as a poignant reminder of the risks inherent in space exploration and the critical need for stringent safety measures. It was a wake-up call for NASA and the entire aerospace industry, prompting a reevaluation of procedures, protocols, and organizational structures. The tragedy became a catalyst for change, spurring a renewed commitment to safety and a profound understanding that the human pursuit of knowledge should never come at the expense of human lives. It also led to over 16 years without any further disasters, ending only in the second and last space shuttle disaster. That is the Columbia space shuttle disaster. The lessons learned from the Challenger disaster continue to resonate with us always, and truly serve as a constant reminder that exploration and innovation must always be coupled with unwavering diligence, rigorous testing, and a deep commitment to the safety of those who venture into the unknown.